So this question, question four, you need to solve inequality. All right, so inequality is, there are two expressions connected with inequality sign. So here is inequality sign more equal. So the left expression is more equal than the other one. And you need to categorize and find what type of equation, sorry, what type of inequality you have. So you have linear inequality. So this is linear. And that means the approach is pretty straightforward. Combine like terms on one side and the other type of like terms in the other side. For example, I can combine 7x and 2x on the right side. So that's why I don't touch, as you can see, inequality sign. I keep that as it was before, right? So I just want to put it more properly. So more equal. And on the right side, when I transfer 2x to the other side, I change the sign and I have this. So what about the left side? 6 plus 8, because I transfer negative 8, I'll get 6 plus 8. After simplifying, I'll get 5x on the right side and 14 on the left side. Then I divide it by 5 and I'll get 14 over 5 more equal than x. So that's basically the solution, but normally we rewrite as x goes first, then you compare with the number, and the number is 14 over 5. So the solution is x less or equal than 14 over 5. And as you can see, x is a rational number. In this case, it's a fraction. You can convert into decimal. It'd still be a rational number because all integers also adhere to Q as rational numbers. All decimals also adhere to Q, except for irrational numbers like thirds, square root of 3, square root of 2, they don't refer to that. Okay, so what we need to do, we need to draw solution on number line, all right? So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to use that, let it be the number line, and right now I just want to draw. So I put 14 over 5 as the point that I fill it up, right? It's filled in point, 14 over 5. And the solution x less or equal. So I'll fill it because inequality is not strict. So it allows to include the edge point, right? Which is 14 over 5. And also I shade everything below or less than this value. So that's going to be solution. It goes up to negative infinity. So that's the second answer to the second part. And finally, you need to give the solution using interval notation. So you just simply convert this notation using number line or using inequality into interval notation. What does mean interval? You're just thinking about this span. It goes from negative infinity to the number 14 over 5. This is the right edge or the right boundary. I put a square brackets because I'll include that, otherwise I will use round brackets. And for infinity, positive and negative infinity, for both of them you need to use, or you should use, round brackets. And then I'll write x stick to the interval or is from. So actually this is sometimes called set notation. Set notation, be careful about this. And that's going to be solution. All right, so we've accomplished four, and we'll move to the next part.